Do you see the presentation?
Yes, Leonor.
Is okay?
Isso é bem.
Sim, Leonor, sim.
Okay. So in this first slide, I would like to give you an overview about the contents. And I would like to start with my presentation to tell you that, as all you know, regular seafood consumption is strongly recommended by most dietary guidelines, since it is an important source of essential nutrients, such as omega-3 fatty acids, vitamins, namely vitamin A, D, and B12, and minerals, namely iodine and selenium. And also regarding proteins, they have high biological value. And in addition, the seafood consumption is part of the culture of many countries, many societies, and it provides non-monotonous meals due to the diversity of species. It is advised by most dietary organizations that people should eat at least 2 meals a week. However, this is not always attained due to several reasons, mainly due to the intrinsic smell that is very appreciated by some consumers, but less appreciated by others, and also the presence of bones. In this situation, one objective of the Seafood Tomorrow project was to make seafood products more attractive for all population segments and to create high quality tailor-made dishes using sustainable and underutilized species that are important and are able to meet the specific nutritional and functional needs of different population groups, namely children, pregnant women, and seniors, without special safety issues. And also, it is very important to inform processing, retailing, and catering places, consumers, to make informed choices in order to maintain biodiversity, preserve aquatic systems, and ensure the availability of seafood proteins for future generations. Within the frame of the Seafood Tomorrow, it was sought to devise a specific strategy. As you know, the development of new dishes have been studied by several teams and several strategies have been proposed. But inside the project, the strategy was specifically designed and it was considered to have 5 steps. In the first step, the selection of sustainable seafood species. The second step, define nutritional and functional criteria for the 3 population segments based on various assumptions. The third, organize national and European contests to select the most appropriate dishes. Then to decide the final reformulation of all dishes, all winning dishes. And in the fifth step to organize and prepare semi-industrial production of the 6 winning dishes. Then I would like to tell a little bit about each step. Regarding the seafood species selection, It was foreseen the participation of all partners in this work package, ANFACO, CIMAR, IDMER, ILVO, RAISE, ZUT, and it was decided that each participant country or institution will select four species. Once again, taking into consideration the sustainability of marine stocks and the responsible farming practice. The current utilization, low or underutilized, economic criteria, low or medium commercial value, and environmental contamination. And the sustainability was validated by Ethicocean. In what regards the second step, nutritional and functional criteria for three population segments were considered. The target population groups were children, 8 to 10 years old, pregnant women, 20 to 40 years old, and seniors. Regarding the nutritional focus, both for children and pregnant women, omega-3 was the quantity of omega-3 was a focus. The vitamin D was focus for all segments of population. Iodine was specially considered for pregnant women, and regarding seniors, vitamin B12, low salt content, and high protein were considered. Moreover, the industrial production feasibility was also considered, and a limited price considered for the production cost per complete dish and per person was between 1.5 and 2.2 euros. How the selection of dishes was preferred? Some cooking schools from the participating countries were invited to involve students in the recipes design, respecting the criteria previously defined for each population segment, aiming to present the most innovative recipes to national contests. So, national contests were organized in six European countries: Belgium, France, Poland, Portugal, Spain, and Sweden, among the cooking schools involved. The recipes were selected with the presence of a jury representing the seafood industry, the distribution, the catering companies, chef, nutritionists, researchers. And then some recipes were selected based also on the organoleptic properties. And all these the recipes selected at national level were invited to compete in Paris in an European contest. And at this European contest, six dishes were selected, two per each target group. Also in this case by an international panel of representatives of the seafood food industry, distribution and catering companies, chefs, nutritionists, and researchers. And in this contest, six winning recipes were considered, for children, ocean pout fish balls, carp sausage with vegetables. Regarding pregnant women, blue whiting with cabbage roulade, and salted common Deb, and for seniors, hearty mussel soup with fish stock and blue whiting fish balls with vegetables and marinara sauce. Okay, after the selection, it was necessary to reformulate the dishes, taking into consideration different aspects. The first one were the assessing in terms of compliance with the nutritional and functional requirements and their feasibility at industrial level. It was necessary to introduce several adjustments based on a refined nutritional calculation based on SQL tables. And also it was necessary to evaluate the potential behavior of dishes, constituents, not only raw materials, but also ingredients during frozen storage, during defrosting and heating prior to consumption, considering microwave or oven. Finally, the list of ingredients and the nutritional information was established for label purposes. And also guidelines for use was also prepared for consumer information. You can see in the picture some of the information that was considered and provided in each packaging. After this work, the semi-industrial production by Idmer was started. And in what concerns raw materials, ingredients, fresh and frozen raw materials were used, fish and mussels. And in what concerns ingredients, fresh, frozen and dried were used. And most of them were obtained from industrial food suppliers or wholesalers. In what concerns the processing, the recipes were developed, as I told, by Idmer, by using classic culinary processes widely used in food industry, using industrial equipment. Regarding packaging, the individual meals were packaged manually in skin trays, and then after cooling, under refrigeration, freezing, quick freezing in an air blast freezer tunnel, and skin packed with a top web cryovac was used, and the storage was performed at minus 18 degrees as in the commercial chain. These six dishes in semi-industrially prepared were then full characterized in terms of nutritional value. And here you can see the chemical composition. In what regards the chemical composition, it was very important to see if the relation between protein and lipids respected the value that was considered in the guidelines. Only one recipe, the recipe number two, was less than the value that the foreseen value was 2, but is quite close the 2. Regarding minerals, that was considered a very important aspect. What we can say? We can say that all dishes contain a significant amount of iodine. Although, as I told you, iodine was an assumption only for pregnant women, but all dishes exhibited significant amounts. So all of them can include the claim saying that they are high in iodine. I also would like to show you that in what regards sodium and the potassium relation, according to FAO, this relation to respect and to contribute for cardiovascular prevention should be less than one. And we have here two dishes that very well balanced, and the others did not exceed 1.5, so they have also a good ratio sodium-potassium. Regarding vitamins, all dishes, the six dishes, reach the target quantity defined for vitamin D. And additional, we can say that a claim they are high in vitamin D could be stated. And regarding vitamin B12, that was a target for seniors, we can say that these two dishes are high in vitamin B12. Considering fatty acids are well known by their role to prevent several diseases, mainly cardiovascular diseases. What we found monounsaturated fatty acids were the predominant in five dishes, unless the dish three. All dishes reach the target quantity of EPA and DHA defined in the previous guideline, higher than 80 milligrams per 100 grams and 100 kilocalories. It is important to say that the better polyunsaturated omega-3 and omega-6 the better ratios were found in dishes 3, 4, and 5. And in what regards cholesterol, the levels no high relevant values were found. Regarding the saturated fatty acids, we have in some relatively high values, but it is not considered in any way a concern. Regarding the risks, the total mercury values were in all the six dishes below the limit for fishery products and most of the seafood muscle meat. PBDs were between non-detected to very low levels. However, BDE-47 was the most frequently detected. Regarding the PAHs, subjected to regulation, they were not detected. Histamine was not detected, and regarding microbial growth and contamination, several determinations were performed, and the results were lower than the limits of the detection or below the legal or the recommended values. Nutritional contribution of these dishes. Regarding protein, the nutritional contributions are defined. EFSA in 2019 defined several aspects. And in what regards protein, in all dishes for children, pregnant women, and seniors, we have relevant contributions. Regarding EPA plus DH levels, the meals respected the nutritional contributions required. Even in what regards pregnant women, these dishes may provide intakes important levels of the DHA that are quite important for pregnant women. It is also important to stress that high contents of vitamin D and vitamin B12 were found, and the iodine levels were quite important. In conclusion, what we would like to say that this strategy advocated in the scope of this project work very well. It proved to be adequate regarding the design, development and the semi-industrial preparation of these six new dishes. And I would like to acknowledge to several colleagues that give very good contribution for the obtention of these results. And thank you very much. And if you have any questions, please, I am free to answer. Thank you very much.